care less about what the Christian community thinks of me. I could care less. I could care less about what the Christian community thinks of me. I could care less.
What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host for this YouTube channel, back with another video. Now, I'm sorry to say, it saddens me to say that I believe we are watching the career demise of Kirk Franklin. We've watched this man come out on stage from the very beginning telling this story that we don't know if it's real or not, about being an orphan and adopted by a little old lady who taught him to play piano and sing gospel songs, and this is the reason why I sing, to later coming out and admitted that he was addicted to pornography, which affected his marriage. And we've seen the production and quality of his music go from worshipful to downright commercial and having nothing to do with God. In a recent interview where he gave an excuse for the demonic Grammys, he wouldn't even mention Jesus in the video because he's caught up in an industry that takes the best of us and chews us up and spits us out and sends us back home if we're lucky and we don't lose our life in the midst of the game. I recently came across this promo video of a new show that Kirk Franklin is working on TV One called The One, where he and his wife are working with singles, not in a singles ministry context, but in a The Bachelor or Bachelorette type of context. And that's fine. If you want to be an entertainer, go full bore and be an entertainer. Give your life to Satan, sell your soul to the devil, but don't straddle the fence, Mr. Franklin. Don't be a lukewarm Christian trying to make music that says one thing and trying to get the Hollywood bag on the other hand that says a whole nother thing about who you are and what you represent. This is ratchet television. And he says, well, he's teaching how to have a healthy and thriving relationship. You know how to have a healthy and thriving relationship, Mr. Franklin? Keep your relationship off of TV. Keep your relationship off of social media. Keep your relationship out of the entertainment game. Let's check this out.
Most people don't know when it comes to love. Tam and I are the unofficial matchmakers, and now we're switching up the game, bringing our matchmaking expertise to the TV screen.
Get naked on the first date.
We will share our wisdom when it comes to getting and maintaining a healthy, thriving relationship.
It's time to find the one.
Do you want to come to the mansion?
Me and my girl Tammy, we're going to switch up the game a bit right here. Yeah. We're going to take an eligible bachelor and an eligible bachelorette.
They both have struggled to find that special someone.
We're going to make them live together as they both go on a mission to seek and find
love. Yeah, yeah,
yeah. We bring the best singles Atlanta has to offer for dates.
Lord have mercy.
Activities. To see if we can help Brent and Ashley find the one.
Let's get this party started.
All right, now.
I like that. Y'all working hard. Working for love.
I know you so nice and so sweet, but I want to grab them ass cheeks.
We're all just as emotionally invested, and this ain't easy for us right.
to get. Anybody heard from Ashley?
Anybody? No?
Ashley's disappearance is very confusing and mind-boggling to us all.
She's jealous. I definitely think Ashley has feelings for Brent.
You do me honor.
What?
I got a bullet on my back.
You don't think I got one on mine?
It's a dating experience unlike any other. With shocking twists.
I just want you to be aware that it's game out here.
That no one saw coming.
What the hell was that? Let's get it.
I'm it. I'm the it.
I am the one.
I am the one.
Yeah, I'm the one.
And without further ado,
the person that I'm going to choose to be the one.
This is one of the hardest decisions I've ever made in my life. I am choosing.
Now, Kirk Franklin is clearly unrepentant, and he's going for the bag. Can't nothing stop him at this point. The man has turned himself over to a reprobate mind. He's disconnected himself from his roots in the church and the gospel, and he going for it, y'all. It's full speed ahead to get that bag, because he's had a taste of that lifestyle. And it's hard once Hollywood introduces that money to you. It's hard not to fall in love with it. And Hollywood knows that. That's why they reel you in the way they do. They've been doing this for decades. And many people stronger than you and I have fallen victim to this. And it seems like our brother Kirk Franklin is the next in line. I feel sorry for the brother, but I continue to pray for him because I know that God is able. And even in his prior addictions and what appears to be a current addiction to the lifestyle, to the money, I know that God can see him through it. God can bring him out. God can restore Kirk Franklin. Even after all this foolishness, God could bring him back. And he would be an even greater witness than he was before. You know why? Because we would have watched him from the very beginning. We would have saw his ascension. We would have saw his decline. And we would see God restore him through his everlasting grace. If you agree with me, let me know in the comments what you think about Kirk Franklin and his wife, his boo, putting together a TV show as matchmakers that looks like ratchet television. Ain't nothing Christian about this. Let me know what you think. And like the video. Subscribe to the channel and share the video so we can get more people involved in the conversation, y'all. And like I always say, always remember and never forget. Without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time. Peace.